Welcome to the CCAA Men's Soccer National Championship game here from Vassals Field on the campus of Durham College in Oshawa, Ontario, featuring the host, Durham College Lords, wearing their home green and yellow trim, and the visitors, Vancouver Islands, in the white with black shorts. I'm Chris McKee, joined by John Townsend.
Feeling the goosebumps yet?
I'm looking forward to this one, John.
Should be a great game we have here. Two fantastic teams. Quite a few people in the crowd as well on this very cold day in Oshawa.
It's chilly, the temperature dipping as nightfall beckons. The team's taking their ceremonial pregame pick. Referee, by far, this is the best guy I've seen over the weekends doing the national championship game. So not only do I have an eye for player talent, I got an eye for referee talent, I think. So Vancouver Island, feature guy you're going to see, number 10, Shun Takano, the central midfielder. He's the PacWest Player of the Year. Was part of the 2017 National Championship squad for VIU.
The only player from the championship squad as well.
Still left, yeah. And also a CCAA National Player of the Year candidate for Durham. You're looking at number 7, Joshua Lee up front. First team OCAA All-Star and the East Rookie of the Year, as well as number 9, Lerone Young, another first team All-Star. Colin Riley, the left back, number 16, also a first team All-Star. Long ball up. First shot on goal, easy for Kevon Grant, also an OCAA All-Star in his own right. Talked about this in the previous game. I don't think I've ever seen a keeper, and I'm talking any level, be able to throw the ball the way Kevon can, 50, 60 yards on a dime.
He has a truly terrific arm. But the other thing that also impresses me with Kevon Young is his communication ability. So the entire match, he is talking to his defense, talking to the midfield, even sometimes shouting all the way up to the attack, communicating with them, making sure they're all on the same page, and leading them.
So Durham, obviously both teams assured of a medal, long cross in, and keeper dealt with it, and he had Josh Lee all over him. That's Kevin Picard, who was huge in the semifinal game in penalties, a couple big saves against Humber. So Durham has not had a medal in over 20 years, 1999 the last time. They've had two bronze, that's it. Here's Takano. Ball in, but Riley dealt with. And Vancouver Island has mentioned national champs just two seasons ago.
Yeah, Vancouver definitely has a track record of winning or at least placing very high. They've not only won a couple years ago when they had it on their home turf, but they've also come second and third numerous times over the past decade.
Another medal in the bag already. Durham. Pushed out of bounds by Lee. So Josh Lee, number 7, that's the real focal point. Josh from Ajax, played at J. Clark High School just down the road, plays for Masters FC in League One. And by far, in my opinion, the best player on the pitch. A lot of the Vancouver Island players sporting a dyed blue haircut.
It's great to see you show team unity, having all the players dye their hair in the same color.
Too much on that ball from Riley. Trickles out of bounds. So if you are out there watching us on the stream, any comments, you want to let us know where you're listening from, or any problems with video or audio, drop me a line on Twitter at Mr. McKee, MRMCKEE. It's the quickest way. So in between this game, I was having a little watch on the live stream, the women's national final game on right now in Edmonton, and they're playing in about 6 inches of snow. and probably a lot colder than what we're experiencing here today.
Don't even want to believe that. Just to think what the commentators and fans there would have to be dealing with, that level of cold.
That's one of those. Is the game over yet? Okay. Did we win? Okay, great. Yeah.
Just counting down the seconds.
Play the advantage. Michael Hoppel was fouled. Ref let it go.
Michael Hoppel from Kamakura, excuse me, Japan.
Just go with Japan.
Yeah, I'll do it next time.
Good pace of the game. We're through the first 5 minutes. Wide open, look, Arbor! Oh! Well, that would have been splendid.
Certainly would have been. I have no idea who was supposed to be marking him, but he was wide open there. Perfect position in the box for a volley.
Taylor Arbor on his left foot hammers in, and it just missed. Well, that would have been lovely. So VIU showing signs of life in the first few minutes. Was it 1999, Durham's last medal? And was chatting with Ken Babcock, the athletic director here for Durham, says that was the last year Durham hosted that year. That was the last time both the men's and women's were in the same city at the same time.
That would have been a logistical nightmare for them.
Yeah.
Well, the Medford was organizing that one.
Games here and then as well down at the Oshawa Civic down the road. And that hit Young in the chest. Ref didn't have the angle we had on it. But he's calling a handball. Lerone, a third-year player. Mentioned off the top, first-team OCAA All-Star. Ooh, hard tackle in. Spittle down the right side. Was key in Durham's 2-0 win yesterday.
Stopped yourself there in the nick of time.
Senchar, the goal scorer for Vancouver Island yesterday, the 6'6 defender. Key on set pieces, and he got in, got a flick of the head. Put it past Nick Fernati, the Humber keeper. And then they ended up winning in penalties. Ooh, Arbor. Stumbled. Kavon Grant, the keeper from St. Mary's High School in Pickering. I watched him play a couple games. He's down the road from me. Lerone Young. And well back. Who was that? Looks like Diego Carlazzoli flicked it out. He was trying to flick it to his keeper, but just got it to safety with Lerone Young creeping.
Yeah, Diego Colazzoni has definitely been my one to watch over the past couple games. I've seen every single VIU game, and even as a freshman, he plays with a level of calmness that you typically do not see from freshmen. Whenever he's on the ball in the game, he always seems to know what he's doing and has year experience beyond his years. He's such a great wing back for VIU.
Corner in, and unfortunate ricocheted off two Vancouver Island players, as you were, we'll do it again. From my money, if you make a free kick or a corner kick like that, it's I want someone else for the next one. Look, you blew the last one. Someone else take it.
Mm-hmm.
Redemption, ball circling in, the wind took it, and Kevin Picard just falls on it.
Probably also in the championship game, nobody wants to be shown up like that to go, yeah, no, you're off corners.
So interesting no backup goalie listed on Vancouver Island. So we may see a Kyle Walker situation if any card or injury. Arbor crosses in and cleared away. Ryan Cullen.
We went to Rio Ferdinando or John Terry, I believe. Both those players went in net at some point.
Yeah. Yeah, I've seen Rio play goal before.
Oh, a bit of a push in the back there from Aiden Donaldson, and referee's going to call the foul.
So a couple great messages here. Mike Davidson watching from 100 Mile House, BC. Go Mariners. And Erlanda Gonzalez Price. So cheering my VIU University from home. Let's go Mariners. And then cool message here. Mike Carney, Durham, 1987 alum, bronze medal winner. Watching from Mississauga. Go Lords. I mentioned if you are out there, let us know. At Mr. McKee on Twitter.
And at John Townsend 99 as well.
There you go. That's great seeing the alumni watching. 87, that was a great year of music. The year the Joshua Tree came out by U2, my favorite album of all time. Arbor, been active in the first few minutes. Takano. Probably the most skilled player on the pitch. Gorgeous little flick ahead. Low cross in and cleared away by Durham's defense.
How Takano is able to just flick that pass in to loft it enough to where it doesn't go out of bounds, but it's far enough ahead to where his player can run onto it is just phenomenal. Takano is just an incredible player.
This guy's a winner at all levels, won a national high school championship in Japan, national championship in college in 2017, and he's looking for another in 2019 here in Oshawa. Cross in, Senchar the big man, and someone getting called with a push. Cole, so dangerous, 6'6", and he's one of those guys that wants the ball. You know, just I've seen a lot of tall guys that don't want the ball in their head. Cole is, put it to me, I'll put it away.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's especially at this level where a lot of players are. You might have quite a few 6 feet tall players, 6'1", 6'2", 6'6". You can't teach height.
Tyreek Brown, the center back, long ball up for Lee. Tyreek, really a special defender, was so sound in the semifinal win. Young flicks ahead. Marcellus Paul, number 11 down the left. You'll be hearing his name a bit. Speedy left winger. Good football. In the opening 12 minutes. Some nice touches from both sides.
Just looking at Durham's defense right now, they're doing a decent job at closing down the opportunities for where the ball is, but by doing so, I'm looking at Arbor. Taylor Arbor, that is, number 9 for VIU. He has loads of space just to get in behind, and if Durham's not careful, he might have another clear-cut volley like he did in like the opening 5 minutes.
So the real heroes today are those people you see in the back of your screen, all bundled together, sitting on the bleachers, out here supporting, I imagine, a lot of the family and friends of the Durham players.
Not just bleachers, the metal bleachers, the cold metal bleachers. They are the two heroes today.
Reminds me of the old exhibition stadium in Toronto where the Blue Jays used to play, and the Toronto Blizzard, by the way, in the NASL back in the day. I remember going to see them there in the early 80s and had the chance to play at the halftime on the field at exhibition stadium at a Blizzards game, outdoor and Toronto Blizzard indoor at Toronto Maple Leaf Gardens.
That would have been awesome.
It was cool. I remember that as a kid being so dumbfounded, especially playing indoors at the gardens. The ball was rolling around. I was too busy looking up just at the banners and all the names and that. It was...
Yeah, I remember one time at halftime of a Canada rugby game at BMO Field, I went on to play flag rugby at the halftime. About 5 minutes in, immediately ran into another guy, got concussed, the team starts the rest of the match.
Well, hey, at least you can say I played at BMO Field, right?
Yeah. You know, I can't remember because of the concussion, but...
Speaking of BMO Field, Toronto FC tomorrow in the final. I mean, they're going to be, what is it, Century Field down in Seattle. It's completely sold out with 70,000 tickets. It's going to be an atmosphere. Picard slowing things down. He's a second-year player from Chilliwack, B.C. I spent a month there one night. Yeah. This is another one of those on tour with the Wu-Tang Clan stories. So. Kevon Brown safely picks it up. Long kick up for Lee. Right to the other keeper. And thankfully, Lee backed out of that challenge. I didn't want to see a defenseless keeper getting bodied.
Then they might be forced into the Rio position. Or John Terry of playing a position player there. This is another one of those on-tour with the Wu-Tang Clan stories. Fantastic pass from Takano there.
Offside? No. Yeah, it is. Thought so. But again, you see just how special Takano is. So creative. Got him listed at 5'6". But, you know, a lot like the real footballers, you know, you see the Messis and the Agueros, those little guys. I was up on, took a little walk around the pitch during the warm-up, and he's got those quads, those proper footballer, you know, legs. Even though he is a short guy, he's very stout. Tough to push off the ball. He doesn't miss leg day at the gym, from what I gather.
With his skill, he doesn't miss any day for anything. Reminds me a little bit of a Mesut Ozil type.
Another offside. That's two in a row. Who was that on the side? I can't see. 10? No. Can't see that far. Because Takano's 10. Arbor, physical in the challenge. Durham playing with a very disciplined attack. Everyone's holding their lanes. Spittle undresses inside to Josh Lee. He's onside, and there's the finish. Joshua Lee opens the scoring for Durham College in the gold medal game of the national championship. What a finish.
What a finish indeed. Wide open in the box off of a fantastic pass. I want to say Young passed him the ball.
Spittle.
Spittle. Spittle passed him the ball there. Fantastic finish. Durham College now up 1-0.
Joshua Lee, you cannot give him that kind of space. He's such a special player. What a finish. No doubt about it. The second that ball touched his right foot, nothing but net.
Now, also, Spittle and Lee, both first-year players for Durham College.
Long ball. What a start. So, 17 minutes in. Joshua Lee has the breakthrough for the Durham Lords. Now, this should open the game up completely. Spittle back at it again, and he pushes that one too much ahead. Ball rolls out of bounds, goal kick. Wow.
Now also, Spittle and Lee, both first-year players for Durham College.
Couple more messages here. The Rideout family in Nanaimo, BC, cheering for VIU. Go Mariners. And Ambrose Tierney cheering on the Mariners from Halifax. And Brett Upton, Durham alum, 2001, go Lords.
Well, Brett Upton's probably very happy now. The fans also getting into it now. After the Lords scored that first goal, they seem a lot more energized.
Great to see. So we are coast to coast today. It's a good audience. Cross coming in. Riley, left-footed attempt. Dangerous ball flicked.
Oh.
Ball buzzing around it again. It settles. Looks like Ryan Cullen, the defender, pushing ahead. Just fell right to his feet. Easy tap in. 2-0 Durham College.
And the fans are going crazy right now in the seats. I'm not sure who's louder, Chris or the fans.
Ryan Cullen, the fourth-year player from Pickering, just down the road, pushing up on the set piece, and the defender, I mean, talk about a gift right at his foot. You know, sometimes you're like, you don't know what to do with those.
Yeah. Easy tapping for the Lords. Now 2-0. Not even 20 minutes in.
20-minute mark. Vancouver Island stunned here in Oshawa. Now, what a confidence and belief this is going to give Durham. Pushing ahead, and your Vancouver Island desperation setting in early. You cannot concede a third before half.
At the same time, though, with Durham, you can't take your foot off the gas. You need to make sure you cut the head off the snake, try to score another one, but just keep the pressure on defensively.
Paul. And Lerone Young with a tackle right in front of us here at the media center. So this is a brand new media center, sort of clubhouse at Vassals Field. They just switched to the turf last year as well. We're grass forever. There's a handball called against Huppel. Which I had been out a bunch to watch Ontario Tech, or UIOT at the time, both their men's and women's game. My son and I like to make the journey up. Some Saturday, Sunday afternoon, nothing doing. Sit and watch some football for a couple hours. Price is right. They don't charge you anything. So always take advantage of that. Coming up here, checking out basketball, volleyball, soccer.
Definitely a lot of options on campus.
And the crowd not liking that challenge right in front of them over there. And the ref wants to settle things down. Who's he calling? It looks like Carlozzi. No, Griffin Douglas, 14, he's calling over. The 2-14s, Jose Flores, having a bit of a clash. Flores scored the opening goal in the semifinal game on a set piece from 30 yards out. The ball just got away from the keeper, slipped through his hands. But Flores still, he'll take it.
Yeah, exactly.
20 years from now, the story is going to be he painted the top right corner. You know.
But it's great to see Flores in the starting lineup of today's game because he hasn't got much playing time as the season's gone on. More of a utility bench role. But hey, maybe after he scored that goal and had a couple of good performances in the tournament, coach got a better belief in him.
Well, he definitely rewarded Dave Ashfield with the goal in the semi, making him look good. And Lerone Young in trail, and Picard wisely away. Defender let him down a bit. You can see he's having a word with the defender, like, don't put me in that kind of danger.
Getting a little testy as it looked like number 12, Travis Brown, shoved the Lord out of bounds there. Referee didn't see it, though.
Brown right in front of us leaves it for Colazzoli. Of course, medal presentations taking place after the game. We can stick around. Now, if you're Vancouver Islands, one goal before the half, then the pressure, the momentum, even though you're still down a goal, you kind of just playing looser because, all right, we can get them back, and then Durham starts to play a little tighter because, you know, nothing worse than blowing a two-goal lead. Senchar away. Lerone Young apologizes for the ball.
Yeah, that's exactly right. If you're Durham, you can't afford to give up a goal if you have a two-goal lead right now, because going to a break with a 2-1 lead, you feel good that you're in the lead, but you would back the momentum to then VIU, a team that has a pedigree of winning.
Another fantastic ball from Takano. Tariq Brown, and you can't say he didn't get a piece of them. Their laces are literally entangled, their legs tied together. I can't say I've ever seen that.
Wow.
So Tariq can't say I didn't touch him. Dude, you're tied together.
Both have a smile on their face.
Yeah. See that sometimes in the NFL when the two helmets get locked together and they can't separate. Mm. I got to take the helmets off. I've never seen that in football there, this kind of football.
The real kind of football.
25 minutes in. The host, Durham College, with a 2-0 lead over Vancouver Island. I'm Chris McKee, joined by John Townsend here at the CCAA Men's Soccer National Championship. So while we get a break, I explained in some of the other broadcasts, so I also do the play-by-play for the new Canadian Pro Basketball League, the CEBL, as well as professional volleyball, one volleyball. They play in Toronto and Calgary, and also Orangeville Prep, the number one high school basketball team. But I played... So I still play soccer 40 years, my whole life, and excited to be a part of this national championship here at my alma mater, Durham College.
And I'm currently the voice of the Durham Lords for both volleyball and basketball, and as well soccer, I'd imagine, as next season comes on.
Takano, dangerous ball in. Shielded, and it's going to be a corner for VIU. So again, number two here, Cole Senchar. The real danger, if you're Durham, get two bodies on this guy.
Definitely.
I'd like to see Lerone Young marking him. Lerone's a good strapping lad himself, but 6'2", 6'3".
Even Aiden Donaldson, it says here that he's 6 feet tall, but I've been next to him. I know him. He's taller than 6 feet tall. So I'd probably put him at 6'2", 6'3", maybe even 6'4".
Takano in. Great ball. Grant punched away, but it's still... in play. And they're going to have another corner.
It's a nice footwork on the outside from Takano. Almost got by his man. He's definitely someone you just need to stay in front of.
Well done by Grant to punch that away. Stay strong. And Takano again. Another great ball in. Grant has to make a play again. Left-footed cross. Danger. Ooh. Cleared away. That was Lerone Young back defending. Lee steals it. And can't get away from Takano.
It's a fantastic steal, though, from Lee, managing to take it off the defender and almost give it to his teammates for support.
Joshua Lee, certain to be a tournament all-star, if not definitely an MVP candidate. May hear his name called at the end of the game. Great switch out to Paul, and Paul's touch let him down. Ooh, foul on Flores. Easy call for the referee. Another good ball in from Takano. You know, one thing I like from Takano, it's, you know, the higher the level you play at, the passes go to spots as opposed to players, because that player knows he's supposed to be there, so that's where the ball goes. You can see Takano, nice ball through, but nobody reading what was actually the right pass to him. That was the only lane he could get it in.
Yeah, some of the great passes. This is more of a basketball thing, but it even applies to soccer. Like Larry Bird would pass to a particular location, and he wouldn't pass to a player. He'd pass to where he wants the player to go. Just having a great passer on your team makes the whole team better at passing.
Josh Lee had a go from about 35 yards. Blocked. So when we're in the media booth, when someone walks in the door behind us, there's this massive gust of wind, and all our papers start flying everywhere.
And our room turns into a bit of a tornado.
Yeah. And then we turn around and give them dirty looks. Lerone Young out on the flank to Paul. Riley's got to overlap. He's too slow to recognize. The second he had that, Colin should have been full tilt down that left wing. But with a two-goal lead, Riley playing a little tentative. Obviously, he doesn't want to get caught upfield. Colin, an OCAA All-Star himself. Fifth-year player from Whitby, Ontario. So this will be Colin's final college game today. And I know he doesn't want to go home with silver. Picard away. Love when nightfall sets in. The cars driving by in the background. It's a cool visual. Cleared away.
Kind of relaxing. The only issue with nighttime, though, makes it a little bit difficult to see the players' numbers on the far side.
Just past the half-hour mark of the opening half. Senchara for Arbor. Oh, great ball by Young to Paul down the left side.
He has numbers as well in the box.
Steady defense from Vancouver Island. Arbor, unlucky, right idea. But ball rolls out for a goal kick.
Great ball by Young to Paul down the left side. He has numbers as well in the box. Steady
defense. Kevon Grant. In his second season with the Durham Lords. An OCAA All-Star. Flores settles.
Got to say, I really like these Durham Lords uniforms. The crest, it looks very much like a proper football club crest. Just the overall look of them, they're really sleek and clean.
Absolutely. So I was promised some swag for helping out here this week. I've yet to see any, but I think one of those jerseys would sit just well.
You're lucky. I haven't even been promised any swag for helping out.
Well, you're only on the student payroll, aren't you?
Well, yeah, I wouldn't turn down any swag.
There we go, yeah. Riley, left foot in. And awkwardly flicked, and it hit one of the Vancouver defenders, rolls out of bounds. And Flores will try and swing one in here. This time we got. Cross in. Riley. I heard everyone shouting no bounce on the Durham defense, and then they let it bounce.
Can't complain about lack of communication.
Yeah. And foul calls. Nice cross in, headed away, and then Lerone Young clears.
It's been fantastic defense from the Lords so far. And that's crucial because with only 10 minutes left in the first half, if Durham Lords going to the break with a two-goal lead, it's going to be massive.
Great cross by Hopple. Takano, a nice feed in. And touched off one of the Vancouver players. He's calling it offside. Anyway, so... is what it is. Gold medal game, living up to the hype so far. Some great action over the first 35 minutes. Even though VIU down 2-0, but they're nowhere near out of this game. You know, they've had opportunities. They've showed signs of life. Just a little unlucky. Obviously, a great finish from Joshua Lee, showing really his skill. And then the second goal, just a little unfortunate. Ball bouncing around, and the bounce went in favor of Durham.
Definitely. I got to say, for the rest of this game, I'd probably keep my eye on number 17, Billy Bagiopoulos, because in the past couple games I've seen of him, he's been such a difference maker for this VIU team, constantly creating havoc in front of goal, creating chances for his teammates, utilizing his pace. But he hasn't really done much this game so far.
Out of bounds on the far side, Spittle couldn't keep it in.
Billy as well, a PacWest Conference All-Star, with 7 goals and 1 assist.
Senchar. And careless pass ends up on the foot of Colin Riley. Lee controls for Spittle. Taps inside Flores on his right foot, but can't get through.
It's a great pass, though, from Aiden Donaldson. All the way from the fence to Lee and attack.
Ball's gone. Disappeared somewhere in the crowd.
Sadly, it's not like hockey where you got to keep the puck.
Yeah. So my dad, you know, mentioned my parents from Liverpool. Dad's a big Liverpool supporter. He told me, like, back in the day when he would go to Anfield and sit in the cop and Josh Lee's pulled down. Ref plays advantage, though. Marcellus Paul gets by his defender, cross in, and cleared away. So when the ball would go into the crowd in Anfield, people used to bring pins with them back in the day. At a great challenge by Riley. So the second they would catch it, they pop it, and then they'd stuff it in their coat, and you wouldn't know who had it. Durham again on the attack. Marcellus Paul. That's also, they used to have, you know, the standing room only as well, back in the day before the Hillsborough disaster. Cross in. That was what my dad said. When you were standing in at infield, when they scored, nobody would put their hands up and cheer. You just grabbed onto the person in front of you because there would be this giant push forward in the crowd. So you just go, yeah, great goal. But you couldn't cheer. You just grab on who's in front of you. Because if you fell down, that's, you know, you can't get back up. He also said no washroom breaks. People just roll up newspapers because you can't. You know, you're not going to get your spot back.
Wow.
Now we have seated stadiums.
Yeah. That's, that sounds so dangerous, just grabbing onto the person in front of you and...
Well, just hold on for life is what you do. Tariq Brown, second-year player from Pickering. As good a center back as you'll see. Man, too much on that ball.
Would have been a good pass if Baggio was already running onto it. Baggiopoulos, rather. But just miscommunication between teammates.
Approaching the half. No substitutions yet. Some of the other games we've seen today, coaches making sure a good portion of their roster are getting a run. National championship game, you know. This isn't house league. You're not getting orange slices in a treat after the game here.
Nobody's getting a consolation substitution here. Best players play.
Cross in, dangerous for Grant, and well away. That was really put Grant in danger. And great skill on Kavon to just steer that out of bounds. No rebound available. When we talked in the previous game, Champagne's goalie Rouleau, a little bit careless with some of the rebounds. But Grant giving a lesson.
It's good that Grant hasn't been tested all that much, but when he's been called upon, it's been with decent opportunities. So come second half, if VIU comes back.
And there's Grant again on cue.
If VIU comes back in the second half, Grant should be ready for all opportunities.
He's had to be called upon a couple times. He's been up for it.
Ooh.
And a foul against Lee. Yeah, not much in that, but definitely a foul. So Nicole Mulvaney wants to send a message. U14 Oshawa Kicks boys team cheering on their coach, Marcellus Paul, and the Durham Lords today. So Oshawa Kicks, one of the local youth programs here. Arbor flicks ahead and cleared away, Aiden Donaldson. I actually played Oshawa Kicks a little bit indoor. It's men's league indoor. They played down at the Civic a couple years ago.
Nice.
I stopped playing men's league indoor. There's too many fights and stuff. Because, you know, in a game like this, right, let's say you and I are opponents. I foul you. Well, there may be 10 minutes before we're near each other again because the pitch is so big. Indoor, I'm going to be within 30 seconds, I'm going to be within 3 feet of you.
Exactly.
And so it doesn't allow that time for tempers to cool in that. So the second you're foul, I got to get you right back. And it ends up leading to a whole bunch of nonsense. So I stopped playing men's league indoors. Yeah. It's too much.
I get that. For me, I've always loved indoors just because it's constant. You're constantly involved in the game. There's no, I'm going to be on the other side of the pitch for this play. Part of that is then you get no breaks and you're just absolutely dead by the end of the match. But I've always enjoyed playing on a shorter pitch.
I like it because you don't have to run as much. So.
Exactly.
Suits my game just dandy. Yeah. Approaching the half mark. I don't think we're going to have more than a minute or so injury time added at the half. Well, Josh Lee playing the role of agitator, standing slowly over the ball. Cross in. Flicked up. And Kevon Grant settles things down. Long up to Lee. Senchar. Ooh, and that's a hard foul. Tariq Bryan. And a card well deserved. So that's.
I want to say it's Taylor Arbor.
That's it, yeah.
Who's down?
It's a fourth-year player from Campbell River. You know, the VIU coach is calling for a straight red. I don't know much about that. It was a rash challenge and a yellow, definitely. But I think it was more just the way Arbor jumped and the timing of it. I think Tariq was intent on letting him know he was there. I don't think he was trying to be too malicious with it.
I think I wouldn't have been surprised if it was a red. Would I have given it a red? Probably not.
No.
But it wouldn't have stunned me if I saw a red there.
So I want to give a shout out to my old friend Tony Clark, the women's volleyball head coach. I believe they were down at George Brown today. I'm assuming another W. So they're on the bus right now watching us on the live stream, cheering on their fellow Durham Lords. So what's up, ladies? And Tony.
Probably used to hear my voice with me during the games.
So Durham ladies volleyball team currently ranked number 2 in the OCAA and top 10 nationally. Yeah. And you better have won today if I'm giving you guys this kind of love. George Brown usually a less challenging contest for them. They did win today, so thank you. Jordan just came in and gave me the yes.
They're a fantastic team and should go pretty far this season. And Taylor Arbor just got up, looks a little bit dazed, and I've noticed that as soon as he first got up, he wasn't walking the best. Now he's walking a little bit better, but hopefully he's okay.
And a men's team also, I think they won today. They're on the bus. Well, shout out to my guy Lucas on the men's volleyball team, also part of the men's golf team. So I also work for Golf Talk Canada on TSN. I follow Lucas on his Instagram, cross in from Takano. And Grant just lets that roll out of bounds. And there it is at half. Durham Lords with a 2-0 lead. They've been the better side, courtesy of the opener by Joshua Lee. And then the follow, I believe it was Ryan Cullen, the defender, on the second one. Good first half, John.
Fantastic first half. Other than a scary moment right before the stop at halftime. Other than that, great first half from Durham Lords. VIU looks a little bit shaky, not getting their passes through in the final third. Takano's looked great, but just nobody on the other end, as well as I mentioned, Billy Bagiopoulos. Hasn't done all that much today's game. Pass goes through to him, and he takes him a couple seconds to start running onto it. A few things like that, but I feel like once the coach talks to the team, settles him back down, they'll be much stronger in the second half.
So Joshua Lee really spectacular. What a finish. And then even just everything, back to front, Kevon Grant in goal. The defense, really solid. Midfield, creative, lively, back helping out. Laron Young, midfielder, how many times? I've seen him twice clear a ball off the line. And so it's a real full team effort from the Durham Lords. And that's not to say Vancouver Island not the same. They've just been unlucky.
Mm-hmm, definitely.
So I will say, I just got word. So both the Durham men's and women's team won. Men's won 3-0. And the ladies 3-1, I believe. So shout out to all the Durham teams that watching. So we're going to take a couple minutes break here at the half. For John Townsend, I'm Chris McKee. We'll see you back in about 5 minutes for the start of the second half of the national championship game.
I'm Joshua Becker, and I play for the Mount Allison Mounties. It's definitely one of the massive part of my education here. Something I do, I commit a lot of time to it. Definitely helps with time management, figure out when I have to do my stuff. Things like communication, leadership, even time management in the future will be a huge thing when I have a job. It's definitely been a great experience. I wouldn't take it back for anything.
For John Townsend, I'm Chris McKee. We'll see you back in about 5 minutes at the start of the second half of the national championship.
I'm Kirsten Mangold, and I play basketball for the Mount Allison Mounties. Being a student athlete's played a huge role. Obviously, it takes up a lot of time, but I think it's definitely helped me in my academics as well. Specifically, I'm doing research looking at concussions and athletics, so it's been really amazing. Like, I met my roommates and like all of my best friends through athletics, and it's really given me a lot of opportunities.
I decided to choose my academic path is because I think business opens up a lot of opportunities for people. I would like to get back to the community and be a mentor to the younger generation. I like to teach them the balance of being a student athlete. I think it helps me to be more dedicated, more motivated in my schoolwork, to keep pushing and to try to make the best of my ability to do anything.
Athletics have played a huge role in my collegiate experience, as it's given me the opportunity to meet a lot of athletes that are like-minded, that are here to focus on their education but also improve their athletic skills. I know a lot of people around the world don't get this chance, and so to be a student athlete, to study, to play the game I love, and to meet people that have a like mind, it's amazing. It's an opportunity that I'd never want to pass up.
Athletics has played a big role in my overall collegiate experience. Personally, as a student athlete, I am very competitive on and off the field. So when I do really well in a soccer game, I want to do really well in the classroom as well. So I think there's two parts to being a student athlete, which is really important.
Being a competitive athlete at the post-secondary level has impacted me more than I could ever describe. You're a part of such a supportive community, and that has impacted me beyond being in college, but my everyday life. The support I've gotten and how it shaped me as a person, it's indescribable. I'm so happy to be able to continue being a part of that community and support others through it.
For thousands of promotional products at great prices, delivered on time. Trust the promotional product experts at 4imprint.ca. 4imprint, for certain. When the world is watching, your logo needs to be perfect. Trust the promotional product experts. For thousands of promotional products and on-time delivery, go to 4imprint.ca. 4imprint, for certain. When the world is watching and you need your logo to be perfect, you need certainty. At 4imprint, we give you the ultimate guarantee. Because when something has your logo on it, it matters to you, your customers, your coworkers, and to us. Our wide selection always changes to keep up with the latest trends. But there is one thing we deliver that's timeless. Certainty. Explore thousands of promotional products at 4imprint.ca. 4imprint, for certain.
Bite my tongue, bite my time, wearing the wrong sound later.
mine. You should see me in a crowd. Got no one, there's nothing to hide. Watch me make them bow. One by, one by, one, one by, one by. You should see me in a crowd. Your silence is my favorite sound. Watch me make them bow.
See my creativity.
Sugarcoat it. We had a bit of a rough start to the season.
Mom!
So it was time to update Dylan's gear. Kahunaverse.com had it all, including equipment and our team's custom clothing. Looking playoff ready, Dylan.
From prospect to pro, Kahunaverse.com.
Hi, I'm Matt Veers, president of Fairburn Medical Supply. Fairburn is proud to be the official medical supply partner of the CCAA and the national championships. Be sure to shop online at fairburn.com and take advantage of our school rebate program. Follow us on social media for monthly specials. We wish all the best to this year's participating teams and athletes at the national championships, and thank you for your continued support.
And I've taken part in everything from local recreational B tournaments all the way to representing Canada in the World Team Championships. Out of all these years of competition, my time competing in PAC West and the CCA competitions were the most memorable and fun experiences in my career. So I feel very fortunate for the 5 years that I got to play for Douglas College, and I'm very grateful for being able to bring more recognition to my sport. It was an honor to compete for PAC West, and it was a privilege to compete in all the CCAA events.
You may not realize, but the opportunities that you give to student athletes to be able to travel and compete within Canada, not everybody has that opportunity. I think you create dreams for people, and not only did you leave me with long-term memories, you've given me lifetime memories that today I still share with friends, old teammates, and more importantly, my family and my kids.
When I look back at my experiences in the CCAA, despite never winning a medal, any of the 3 times I attended, and 2 times as a coach, I still couldn't tell you a single negative thing I took away from it. I remember thinking how awesome it was to be there, how much the people, the volunteers, treated us like rock stars, how no matter where it was, the venue was amazing. You knew you had come to the big show. I won't lie, there was a lot of learning that happened. We did win a game or two. I did really get beat up, but I loved every minute of it because we were there and not at home putting our shoes in the closet waiting for the next run.
Welcome back for the start of the second half of the CCAA Men's Soccer National Championship game. Here in Oshawa, Ontario, the host, Durham College, with a 2-0 lead at the half, courtesy of a right-footed strike from Josh Lee. And then Ryan Cullen, the defender, off a corner, ball just rolled to him and he tapped it in. And so did we see any substitutions at the half? I haven't noticed anything yet. From Vancouver Island, there was no one with the board, I don't believe. So we'll take a little look here in a minute. But and there's Nick Spittle down the right side and cleared away from Vancouver Island. Mentioned in the first half, if you are out there watching, drop me a line on Twitter. Let us know where you're listening from, at Mr. McKee, MRMCKEE. We have people listening coast to coast, all the way from Halifax out to Vancouver Island. Truly a national broadcast and a national championship. And careless, deep in their own half. So if you're Vancouver Island, and you got to play with a little bit of urgency, but you also want to maintain your defensive structure. But you got to think somewhere around that, by the 70th minute, they got to get one in them. Grant well out of his goal and just clears it away. Sakano with a few skillful passes and trying to get his teammates involved, but still fairly quiet in that first half. And he went to ground way too easy. And then, you know what? I don't like that. It's Huppel, a little too mouthy with the ref. I think the ref was a little generous there. Just.
Then again, 2 minutes out of halftime, don't even want to award a card for, you're talking to me.
Yeah.
I agree, though. It is annoying. Almost want to just go, play on.
In the words of Robert De Niro, you're talking to me. I have a hard time seeing through the window, so you got to really peer through. We got a glass pane in front of me here on the left side. The window's open to the right.
Also, if you go to the right side, though, it is just constant cold.
Vancouver Island wanted to take it quickly. Wisely, Lerone Young stood over it. Allows his team to settle. And Donaldson clears away.
Great clearance from Donaldson. I have no idea how he's able to generate that much power from, no run-up. Just seemingly flicked it.
Spittle. Gets by both defenders. Spittle. And he got by two and couldn't make it three.
I feel like the last defender there went number four, Fraser Rideout, went to ground very easily there. Probably wouldn't have given a foul.
And,
Spittle gets by both defenders. Spittle. And he got by two and couldn't make it three.
If you are a person or know someone who sells hot chocolate, you might be able to make a buck or two if you hurry up to Oshawa right now. And big crowd. I'd go $10 a hot chocolate.
Wow, yeah. You are pricey. It's all college students, so none of them have cash in them. It's all tap.
Yeah. Kevon Grant. So Durham came into the playoffs with a 7-1 record, second in the OCAA. Ooh, hard challenge. I believe Algonquin was the top team.
I'm not sure. Good question.
I always remember one of my broadcast partner when I was at Durham, we would do the games, and he, for the life of him, just could not pronounce the word Algonquin. I'm like, this is the seventh game you've done with them. And a hard foul.
A little bit of a stare down from
it's Griffin Douglas. I'd take Lerone Young in that battle any day. Ooh. Lerone.
Abs of steel. Frazier Rideau gets the ball kicked directly in the stomach, does not even flinch.
Cullen, the fourth-year defender from Pickering, threw it in. Nick Spittle over the back of someone went down. Yeah, good call from the ref. He's reckless with his challenge, but not malicious. So another one, it's Tanya Reber, forgive the pronunciation. Watching from Ladysmith, Vancouver Island, go Mariners bleed blue.
Durham College, step up your game.
Yeah,
I think it's only two from Durham so far.
Yeah, and that's fellow Durham athletes and coaches watching. So, and then also, was it Mike Tierney, I believe, 1987. Mm-hmm. Bronze medal alumni, bronze medal winner. So Durham never won a national championship in their history in soccer. And so
potentially until tonight. Potentially.
History in the making. Watching from Ladysmith, Vancouver Island, go Mariners bleed blue. And what's Cullen doing? I can hear one of his teammates say, what are you doing? He was way too nonchalant. Baggyopoulos and then Tyreek Brown, if you need him.
Sends it over to Whidbey. Just absolutely clears the ball.
Takano. I'd love to see Shun play just a little bit higher up the pitch. He's playing almost that holding midfielder spot.
Yeah.
And I want to see him. I'd love to see him play just behind that striker, get a few more chances on goal. His creativity around that 18-yard box is what Vancouver's been lacking.
I feel like he's kind of been forced to play in that holding midfield role just because nobody's been able to get the ball up towards him.
Lerone Young. And blocked by Vancouver Island, will go out for a corner. As you can see in the background, the snow, which was cleared away on the field when I pulled in here Thursday morning to call the games, there was easily 30, 40 volunteers out on the pitch shoveling all the snow. It was a good 6 inches of snow that covered the field. And so kudos to all those volunteers and their effort. Corner taking a while. Cross in, kept away. Flores, swing and a miss. Young, out to Spittle. Hard drive, and Picard was needed to punch that away. Nick Spittle has been dangerous all evening.
Sounds like the crowd's getting involved in the game now. From these attacks at Durham, it's got the crowd energized.
Spittle, a first-year player from Ajax. Which is just 15 minutes east of here. Or west of here, excuse me. Cross in, Picard punched away. And Flores I believe that's strike two for him.
Just a bit outside. Yeah.
Young. Durham playing very deep. They've got the lone striker up top, Joshua Lee, and everyone else back playing a really tight shape, making it very difficult for VIU to find any space to move. Grant off the side of his foot. Ooh, hard challenge. That's going to be a card from Lerone Young. And he sees yellow. So, well done by the ref. You can see all the Vancouver Island players taking exception to that. And he was very, look, I got him. I'm going to card him. Communication, that's all you want. Exactly. You know? That's why you ever sit on the GO train, you're sitting there, and they just stop in the middle of the tracks for 20 minutes, and you're like, can someone just at least tell me what's going on?
Now I stole that, I'm upset.
Yeah. It's just all it needs, a little communication while bouncing around. Poked ahead, and Huppel, and someone was offside. Unlucky, because Huppel was wide open with no one in front of him, right at the 18-yard box, the top of it.
Put the shot wide, though, so.
Yeah. At least put that in, so.
It's not going to count, at least at the target. It's now looking very dark out in Oshawa. The sun's completely fallen. It's not even 6 o'clock yet. Someone was offside. Unlucky. Nice pass from Jose Flores.
Bagiopoulos down the left side. Cuts in. Leaves for Takano. Shun. Clever little flick. Nice ball in. Takano wants to have a crack at goal. Look at the pace of Josh Lee.
VCIU over the past couple minutes has looked much better at building up their offense, their attack, getting the stars in the right position to have a crack at goal.
Spittle again.
Spittle's also been a menace on this wing.
And cleared away and kept in. Nicely done. Ooh, Grayson Shalafo. Oh, great ball in by Takano. Bagiopoulos. And then that's flicked away, Aiden Donaldson. So Shun showing his creativity.
Yeah, if you're Billy cutting in on your right foot, you need to try to fake going one way because everyone knew the ball was going to be there on that side of your foot. Aiden Donaldson with the easy standing tackle to get the ball out, to get the ball away from him.
Cross in. And there it is! Is that Cole Senshaw again? The big man, 6'6". This time, doesn't need his head. Ball just falls to his feet, and he taps it in. Now we got a game, 2-1.
2-1, 30 minutes left. If you do them, you need to snap out of this funk you've been in so far the second half. Wake back up, Try to get a goal, make it 3-1. If not that, make sure you do not give up any easy chances on the other end.
Now all the pressure on the home side, Lords. You have a 2-0 lead where you think, oh, we're comfortable. They're already engraving my name on the medal, the gold medal. And then Cole Senshar, again, has been so dangerous on set pieces. I mean, that 6-foot frame, 6-foot six frame, just how do you mark him? And so now VIU playing inspired football. Bagiopoulos cuts in. Man, Aiden Donaldson up the field.
Donaldson's played a fantastic game so far, being a great ball-playing center back. Whenever he's had an opportunity to boot it up pitch, whether it's a clearance or a cross, he's done so. He's done a great job of marking the opposing team.
One thing I loved after that goal, right away, as soon as Senshar scores, no celebration. He screened at someone, get the ball, and he sprinted back to his position. Let's go. Still plenty of work to do for Vancouver Island. But, you know, at the start of the second half, we talked about how you want to get one at least by the 70th minute so you don't start pushing up too much. Now they can just relax and play their game, can still play a solid defensive game.
I would typically agree, but I don't know if Sean Takano is going to be willing to relax. He's trying to get this team to go and put one in the next 10 minutes if he had to take a pick. This VIU team has come out in the second half ready to play, came out with a much different level of intensity and a different level of cohesion with one another. Billy Bagiopoulos has played a monster second half so far, getting them much better positions, much better places and locations on the pitch to have a couple cracks at goal.
So we will have overtime if this is tied at the end of regulation. 2:15s, I believe, is what will happen, and then to penalty kicks following that if they're still deadlocked. No, what do you get it away, Donaldson? That's one thing I don't like. When the defender is assuming his goalie is there to clear it, it's the goalie makes the call. You never let a defender make the call for the goalie.
Exactly. You don't want to open up the door for potential miscommunication. You just want to, don't even think, clear it.
And it was Donaldson being like, hey, I know you're 20 yards away, but can you come pick this up right now? That's not the call you want to make. Hupple crosses and safely dealt with by Grant. And that was off Senchar's head. A lot of the Durham fans on that field looking for a foul. Senchar all over the back of Joshua Lee. And finally, a foul called. Let's see who's on the ground. It looks like Young was fouled, Lerone Young. And now Jose Flores will come in on his right foot and try to swing this in. Flores scored in the semifinal.
His favorite player is Cristiano Ronaldo, and he has a bit of a Ronaldo approach to free kicks.
He's got that stance, yep. Yeah. Cross in from Flores. Dangerous, and it finds the back of the net. Deja vu, Jose Flores. It was the exact same thing yesterday in the semis. A goalkeeper error that allowed the breakthrough, and now maybe it's a goalkeeper error that allows a gold medal around the necks of the Durham Lords.
You know what? He's not going to label it as a goalkeeping error. He's going to view it as, you know what? I just did a Cristiano Ronaldo free kick.
So Flores, I don't think he was going at goal. It was just try to cross that in, and he handcuffed the keeper. Just, and that's got to be crushing for VIU. They fight their way back in.
5 minutes later, down same amount.
And it was from a very similar spot, probably about 5 yards back yesterday's goal from Flores, but the exact same result. And again, you know, 20 years from now, Flores will tell you, man, I picked that back right corner. It's gorgeous.
Durham. The top right corner.
Yeah. Takano again with a splendid pass ahead. Grant, oh, well done. Three-one, and the Lords can breathe a little easy. Yeah, no one up yet, warming up for either side. You would think around that 65-minute mark is when substitutions on the minds of both managers.
It looks like Lavone Young just got hit in the back of the head on that header. He's holding a little bit. Looks like he's okay though.
Marcellus Paul. Nice feed in to Lee, and he goes to ground. No. I think if Lee goes to ground there, he's got to shout for a penalty.
That's a change from you. You know, saying players should go down?
Well, there was enough contact that, you know, you could. And also, you understand where the ref's behind. So if you see that kind of contact, he's going to buy it.
Just a bit of a change of tune from you, normally saying the players should always stand up no matter what.
We'll see. These linesmen brave. I don't see any toques or gloves on any of these guys, especially the guy right in front of us. He's out here roughing it. Bagiopoulos. Not much in it.
Guessing the linesman used as motivation to just keep running.
That's it,
to keep their body warm.
VIU. Spittle. Ooh, dangerous tackle. Two-footed challenge, and
wow.
The ref keeps his whistle in his pocket. Takano, the ball bounces to him. And they're calling handball on Cullen. Cullen took exception to that. And you got to love that. You call that little ball to hand, but not that two-footed slide challenge from behind.
As soon as that slide challenge came, I thought, okay, could that actually be a borderline yellow card? I never even considered the referee wasn't going to call that as a foul. And then that handball right there could have been ball to hand as well. I'm not entirely sold that it was a clear-cut handball.
So Bagiopoulos and Takano, looks like they both want it. And it looks like Takano's going to stand over it and have a go.
Shed Takano just looked at him, pointed at his arm, and go, look, I'm the captain.
Yeah.
This is mine.
So the PacWest Player of the Year, first team All-Star. Whatever award you can achieve in the PacWest, Takano has got it on his resume.
You can hear the Durham coach saying something about other side of the wall. Just a bit of throwback to Stan Van Gundy screaming to build a wall during a timeout.
Takano, right-footed strike, and Joshua Lee heads it away. And if that, and you got to love to see that. Strikers usually get the, remember the diva reputation, Lee in there taking one for the team.
This wind is really powerful up here.
Yeah, so we can say, I've been holding my lap. So the wind just came and swept John's roster sheets away, and they've just flown out the booth. So now I'm going to have to be nice and share my rosters. Highlight of the night. That's a TSN turning point right there. It's that one gust of wind.
Yep. It's from that door as well, the door we spoke about earlier.
I need a sip of water after that.
But that free kick though from Takano, you're going to have to look at that as a missed opportunity. Free kick right on the edge of the box, perfect chance to cut the lead down to one, and he's just unable to hit it.
So I would say rip out one roster, tape it to the next one, and there we go.
Only problem is that's what I did with this program before.
That's the one. So there's another one sitting there. Yeah.
Hopefully it has both teams.
Just under 20 minutes left. Durham College. 20 minutes away from history. Lerone Young, and just gives it right back to Vancouver Island. Shalafo. I would say Tariq Bryan, the Durham defender, number 3, definitely on my tournament all-star list.
Jose Flores somehow managed to stay on his feet and ended up losing control of the ball, but kept it for a lot longer than I was expecting.
And Young made a meal of that one, and the ref bought it. So
yeah, I still have it in my hands.
Does that one have the new rosters?
Yes, it does.
Okay,
as well.
Good. Here we go. Okay.
I thought you were wondering with the gust of wind whether or not my rosters flew out the window again.
No, I was just making sure you're still good. And the two Vancouver Island players challenged themselves on that one. Communication. They need to be more communicative. I was so hung up on that word 2 days ago, I couldn't get out of my mouth, so I'm very proud that I was able to deliver that. The crowd really in it on the far touch line. Great to see.
Just over 15 minutes left before Lords can start celebrating, but they're not quite there yet. More than enough time for VIU to make a comeback. Need to be more communicative. I was so hung up on that word 2 days ago, I couldn't get out of my mouth, so I'm very proud that I was able to deliver that.
Still no sign of a substitute yet from either side. Swung in, dangerous. Falls right to a VIU player. Hupple goes to grounds.
Went to ground a little bit easy there, Hupple did.
Hupple, the Pac West Rookie of the Year.
I feel like you can always tell when a player goes to ground a little bit too easy by the reaction of his fellow teammates. If they don't make a big deal out of it, can't tell at that point.
And great hustle back, Nick Spittle.
Spittle's been fantastic today. Even though he had, I don't believe he scored a goal today.
No.
Didn't he get an assist on one?
Well, he's just been really creative.
Exactly.
And creating a lot of chances. Joshua Lee. Ugh. Dave Ashfield, none too pleased with that call down on the touchline. You can hear him up here in the booth.
Kind of worried the mics picked him up as well for a second there. Great ball in from Cali Fu, number 20 for VIU.
Oh, another strong challenge. That's Tariq Bryant again. Ooh. Everyone on Vancouver Island wanted that call.
That has to be a call there for the referee.
It is. Josh Lee.
Sancho just went for a piggyback ride over, I want to say that was a.
It's Josh Lee, seven.
Oh, Josh Lee? Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. I thought it was Young for a second.
You can see Lee holding the top of his head a little. Then a bit of a shoving match going on. It was Travis Brown was getting into it with someone on Durham. Donaldson up the pitch, down to Spittle, and Nick can't control. And lovely ball from Takano, maybe just a bit too much. And great hustle. You know what? That's one of those ones, keep it in, just knock it in for a throw-in, though. Knock
definitely.
It out. Rather a throw-in deep, that deep than a goal kick. Alas. Just over 6 o'clock local time. We'll say Michael Heeple is pronounced Heeple, not Hupple. So forgive me. I went and talked to the coaches before both games, and I got the pronunciation from his coaches. Let me see that again. Read that. So it says Michael, is it Heppel, is pronounced he as in hello. That's not what you would say. You wouldn't say he, though. That's hell, as in bell. Heppel. Well, there you go.
Nothing better from a DM from an angry parent.
I even wrote, see, I have it phonetically, huh, pull. Because that's how the coach told me to say it. Forgive me. Takano. And Tariq Bryan there again. Spittle, one-on-one on Senchar, gets around him. Spittle, and the ball lands to him. Surely it's number four.
Oh.
Second chance, third chance. He can't do it. But what a run, Nick Spittle.
Spittle needs to go out and get a lottery ticket after this match. he just got the luck of the bounce of the ball for four different players.
I don't like the challenge from Senchar. There was no need for him to go to ground there. And if you do go to ground, you better take him out. Offside called against VIU.
Right now I'm looking at a lot of VIU players, in particular the goalie, Kevin Picard. The body language is saying that they're frustrated with the match, frustrated with how it's going. I know that they're on two goals with 10 minutes to play before stoppage time, but I feel like anger, frustration, whenever you show it that outwardly, it never goes well for your team in the end.
So Spittle could have put the game away for Durham. Ooh, over top. With 10 minutes to go, three-goal lead. would have been insurmountable. But now we're just at the 80th minute mark in the next few seconds. And I got to, I'd love to see some kind of new fresh legs come in for VIU.
I suppose there hasn't been many substitutions this match, particularly after the Jose Flores goal.
Long ball in. Flicked out of bounds. It'll be a corner for Vancouver Island. You would talk about the fresh legs. It's really, even in this kind of tournament, 3-4 games over 3 or 4 days, you really need to use more than 11 guys, no matter what team you're on.
Even though you wanted to play your best guys, at a certain point, if they're so tired, bringing in fresh legs, particularly got legs with pace on them to burn the tired defenders, that's just a better option.
Long crack at it, ball bouncing around, and Vancouver Island again gets the second. And this thing's not done yet. I couldn't see who exactly put it in. The ball was just bouncing around off a bunch of white jerseys. But Vancouver Island, 3-2. Durham, they just can't make it easy, can they?
Still no substitutions coming from either side. But the next 10 minutes, or 9 minutes rather, is going to be very interesting. Durham probably going to close up shop here very soon and just go ultra defensive. But right now, that's not really what Young wants to do.
And this thing's not done yet. And that's the dilemma if you're Dave Ashfield. Do I push and try to get one more to put this, to give us that breathing room again? Or if they sit back, you risk that danger. Takano and Bagiopoulos looked way offside. That did get through. Flores up. Marcellus Paul, can he get to it? And he does. Ball stays in, and then
that has to be a card right there. Tackle from behind.
He literally yanked him down. Yeah, there it is.
It's time for another miraculous Jose Flores free kick.
Yeah, hey, he's done it twice. Third time's the charm. Let's go.
Bit more of a more difficult angle here, but he did it from that side previously. I'm sure he's going to be in no rush to take this one as well.
Cullen creeping back up. The big man number 2 wants to get in there as he sends Nick Spittle back to cover for him. Cross in. And this time Picard safely. Bagiopoulos. Takano to Bagiopoulos inside. Drives it and he just missed. Inches past the side of the goal. And we talked about the corner. Cullen, the defender, goes up to get on the attack and he left Nick Spittle back there. And Spittle just got roasted. This guy's normally a right winger trying to play right back. And Bagiopoulos turned him inside out.
I'm unsure why Cullen was up there for the free kick in a poor location spot for a free kick because it's just going to be a cross coming in. And as you mentioned, having Spittle come back, poor decision making there from Lords.
Durham breathes a sigh of relief. Bagiopoulos just missed.
Right now, Tyreek Bryan needs to get a little bit further up because he's playing Bagiopoulos onside.
Flicked away by Brian. The cross from Frazier right out.
Looks like there will also be a substitution as Nate Payne, number 19, is going to be coming on for Durham. He's a defender who's 5'10 from Whitby, Ontario.
I keep having Notorious B.I.G. lyrics in my head, There I am, Major Pain, like Damon Wayans.
That's an awesome throwback reference. Yeah. I was not expecting a Notorious B.I.G. reference.
Cross in, Senchar again, the big man. And Grant over the back of one of the Vancouver. And there's that toss I talked about with Grant.
That's incredible. Wow.
So he threw that from his 6-yard box, probably about 5 yards past half. So that's a good 50 yards on a dime.
Yeah. Got our own Pat Mahomes in net.
Lee up by himself. And that ball kicked onto Simcoe Street.
There's Carr going by right now. Hopefully he doesn't hit it.
Need a new ball in.
Substitution now as Nick Spittle is coming out of the game. What a game he has had.
Yeah, tip of the cap to Nick. Really a stellar entire playoffs. Here at the CCA National Championship. What a week for Nick.
Probably they also made that substitution, so on for further free kicks and such, it allows Cullen to go up, whereas all of a sudden Nate Payne could go back to play the right back, or actually yes, right back role. I always have to take a second to figure out who's the left back, right back.
So under 4 minutes left, we haven't had a ton of injury stoppages, so I can't see much more than about 2 minutes being added. Flores. And Payne, ooh, welcome to the game, Payne. You can see, you know, I could see a mile away he's going to clatter this guy. Mm. He just, that's that, hey, you know what, I've been sitting on that bench. I want to get my adrenaline going. I want to let it be known I'm in this game.
Nick Payne bringing major pain.
There he is. Bam, yeah. Great ball in. Takano dancing down in the left corner and out for a throw in. Cross in. And Lerone Young, a little too casual with it for my taste. Get it up the field.
Try to get it up to Joshua Lee, just put a little bit too far ahead of him.
And it's getting contentious out there. It's Aiden. He's getting into it with Travis Brown, Aiden Donaldson.
Aiden Donaldson needs to settle down. Just focus on the game at hand right now.
Cross in. And foul called against someone on Vancouver Island. Didn't see it.
I believe it was on number 12, Travis Brown. He's also been having a bit of a war of words with Aiden Donaldson.
Nick Payne, the other Payne, was there to clear regardless. I haven't said Nick's name too much tonight. You know, when he's playing next to Tariq Brown. It's a real comfort. And the other Payne again clears that away. Coming to the end of regulation. In the next few seconds, Payne up the field. Well done.
Other than the very fast yellow card he got when he came on, Payne's done a good job defensively, just getting the ball and clearing it right away.
And that looked well out of bounds, but the linesman doesn't say anything. No word yet from the official scorer on injury time minutes. Bagiopoulos, and looked like it went off Bagiopoulos. Four minutes of added time. That's generous. So VIU, you've got 4 minutes to level. Flores.
To be honest, with the unlimited substitutions you can have, why not just bring all the strikers off and have all center backs on the pitch?
I think the speed of some of these guys, I don't know if you're going to get that.
It's fair enough. 4 minutes
of added time. That's out of bounds, Nick Payne again. VIU, you've got 4 minutes. Nick's second-year player from Pickering. A lot of Pickering guys. I'm a Pickering guy myself. Live in the West Shore area. I was down East Shore, or Bay Ridge as they call it, for 10 years. My house backed onto Big M's, the famous burger joint, when I moved just early in the new year to the other side of the bay. Long ball up for Lee. He was onside. Lee settles. Young gets by the defender. Cross in, Flores. And cleared away by Takano. I think Durham a little cash getting back. Nick Payne off the ref.
Oh, how cold it is. He's going to be feeling that sting.
So you wonder, at what point does the keeper get up into the play, Picard? We're in injury time. Durham College trying to make history, their first men's soccer national championship in school history. So someone else was at the change jerseys.
Yes, I believe that was Kalifu. Used to be number 20.
So he's just throwing a jersey on quickly. I think there was some blood on it.
So Kalifu was number 20, now he is number 16.
Jersey sales have already increased online the second he's put that on. It's like when Kobe Bryant switched to number 8, right? Or 24,
yeah,
whichever.
Switch from 8 to 24. Yeah.
Takano in, great ball. Grant got just enough of it.
Surely just a matter of minutes now.
And another ball onto Simcoe Street. A new ball needed. There's one. And cleared away. It'll still be Vancouver Island throw-in.
Thankfully, that one didn't go into Simcoe.
You're looking at $110 a ball. That's a lot of money on Simcoe Street.
You have a call, live close.
Here's the chance. Can they equalize? And there's a scrum at the 6-yard line. Wow. There was just bodies flying everywhere. And finally, the ref blows a whistle. Durham College can breathe a sigh of relief.
Wow. A chance from nowhere for VIU, somehow left open. Here's the
chance. Can they equalize? Well, that's it. I mean, and there's the final whistle. History has been made. The Durham Lords are your 2019 CCAA Men's Soccer National Champions. Congratulations.
And congratulations to the Durham Lords. First. Their first ever national soccer championship for men's, I believe. It just incredible. Came in as the underdogs, I think the only reason why they're here is just because they're hosting it. And they've just gone and won the whole thing. They've played fantastic. And I'd argue they beat the best team here in VIU.
Vancouver Island, dejected. Players just laying on the ground all over the pitch. You really got a feel for them. And, I mean, kudos to them. They're definitely worthy of being in the national championship game. And you can't say the better team won. I can honestly say the luckier team won today.
Definitely. Yeah, both of Lord's second goals. The first one was just wonderfully orchestrated. The second one just came from a great bounce. And then the third, Jose Flores gets another very lucky free kick. That's a bit of a goalkeeper error. Puts it in the back of the net. It's been an incredible game here for the Lords.
You got to feel for the keeper, Picard, on that. But Flores, you know, John, we talked about this from day one of the tournament. Put the ball on net, good things happen. And Flores, evidence of that, two shots from, you know, 30 yards out, 25 yards out. And it ends up in the back of the net, and it ends up being the difference in Durham College winning their first ever national championship.
Definitely.
Great scenes here at Vassals Field in Oshawa. The field flooded with family and friends of the players. Joshua Lee, I'm going to tell you, we got some inside info I just heard over the speakers. Joshua Lee is going to be named MVP. Oh, I said it. Okay. I mean, he was the best player on the pitch from
hands down
at the beginning. Just dangerous. That right-footed strike, absolutely delicious to open the scoring for Durham, and it really set the tempo. But credit, tip of the hat to Vancouver Island. They just wouldn't go away.
Yeah, fantastic thing for Vancouver as well. They shouldn't hold their heads down in shame at all. After going down three goals, to manage to claw back to a one-goal game is incredible.
We were down 2-0, made it 2-1, down 3-1, fought back to 3-2, and then in injury time, had inside the six-yard box, had a couple cracks at it, but just couldn't get it past Kevon Grant. What an effort, what a game, what a tournament.
Exactly. And as a star for VIU, Shantikano, he's an incredible playmaker in the midfield. He's much more than a set-piece specialist, but his set-piece ability allowed VIU to get numerous chances from corners, from free kicks. Didn't get to the penalty stage, but I'm sure he would have been incredible at penalties as well. Just what a talent. And also a great leader as captain. As soon as they scored the goals, he was one of the first guys to go, okay, no, let's get back now. Let's get another one.
Right back to it. Cole Senshar as well, who got the opening goal for VIU to make it 2-1. No celebration. Sprints right back to position. And what a great game. That's it.
Definitely.
So we'll stay on for the trophy presentation here. I can toss out all my notes that I spent a week making.
Yeah, you came very well prepared.
Oh, man. Well, especially, and I didn't get the chance to be prepared as I liked because, you know, each team's got 20-plus players, and when I finally got word that, yeah, I was going to do it, it was less than a week away from doing it. So I just, time-wise, between my other job, to be able to prepare enough notes on every player, a little bit more in-depth. So what I tried to do is focus on, you know, each team, obviously, they've got, you know, conference all-stars and that. I'm going to be talking about those guys. Look at who's got the goals. You know their name's going to be called at some point. So
definitely.
A little bit of info of those guys, and that's that.
Got the same kind of jealous of those championship shirts that all the players have. I've always enjoyed whenever, like, especially when the Raptors won their championship, you just get all the merchandise, all you get everything. Don't even think twice about it. Even I got a black and white shot of the Kawhi shot.
Yeah.
Got that in my bedroom after they won the championship.
A friend of a friend of mine, he's in that shot. He's a season ticket holder to the Raptors, and you can see him clearly. He's about three or four rows back.
That's awesome.
And he's immortalized for life as well. He's in that famous Kawhi shot.
I was actually at that game working, and I got managed to see the Kawhi shot from a completely different angle to what the one at the TV shot. And when I saw it initially, I knew it was going in immediately. But then when I saw the replay of it, like on the TV, it looked like an entirely different shot. And I thought, oh, there's no way that's going in.
Are the Kawhi playing the Raptors, I think, this week coming up? So
it's going to be a great game.
Yeah. I'm always jealous of those guys that can toggle back and forth, English and French. You know, like the Montreal Canadian announcer, like this guy is like say it in English and then
incroyable.
Yeah. You come right back to it. It was like is that Bagiopoulos?
Believe so.
It is.
Actually, no, it's not. It's number seven.
Heppel. Michael Heppel.
Heppel or Heppel?
Heppel. According to the message I got, it is now Heppel. Or Heppel.
Just think of Dave Chappelle.
That's right, yeah. Where's Hudson College?
I don't know.
Well, that's what they're saying.
Hudson College?
Hudson, I think they said. He's going to host next year.
Maybe wherever the Hudson Bay Company headquarters is?
Yeah.
Maybe.
Well, that's in downtown Toronto. So.
Oh, really? Oh.
Well, it's been a fun week just being able to call some soccer.
I think I'm all soccered out, though, after commentating 11 hours.
Yeah, today.
Yeah.
I'm hoping to catch a little bit of that LSU-Alabama game in the fourth quarter. Mm. Catch the end of that, if not.
Yeah.
Some hockey and football on tonight.
Probably good to go on NBA Reddit, see what streams are for basketball. And then get back to soccer tomorrow with TFC playing at 2 p.m.
That's right. No, my pro line ticket is just well out of whack.
College football?
Yeah.
Oh, the Gators win? Or?
Let's have a look here. Well, they were heavily favored over Vanderbilt, I know that. Mm.
Don't watch
56-0. There you go.
Wow. Okay.
So, needless to say, they covered. Yeah.
Don't watch college football at all, but I've always said football. Florida Gators are my favorite football team for college.
I watch all college sports religiously. College soccer as well. I watch a lot of the American NCAA on the Big Ten Network. Mm. So what I think I might do, we'll sign off, and then Nick, do you want us to leave maybe a headset on with a mic so they can at least hear with what's going on. Yeah, we'll do that. So we're going to sign off. Just want to thank all of you for tuning in. We're going to keep the live stream going, but John and I are going to shut the mics off. We will leave the mic live so you can hear what's happening with the presentation. But John, any closing remarks here from Oshawa?
Nothing really, other than thank you for listening. It's been a great pleasure commentating this great final for the Durham Lords.
Well, as a Durham College alum, and want to thankful to, you know, Ken Babcock, Chris Cameron, Scott Dennis, Jordan Hall, everyone for the chance to come back here and be a part of this and be a part of this celebration and watch Durham win their first ever national championship. So for John Townsend, I'm Chris McKee. Thanks for joining us. Till next time.
Tournament most valuable player, the joueur le plus utile du tournoi. From Durham, number 7, Joshua Lee. Please welcome once again Wade Comel and Alan Rogan. Pour présenter les médailles, accueillons Wade Comel et Alan Rogan. The bronze medal winners, les gagnants de la médaille de bronze. Champlain, Saint Lambert, Cavalier. Antoine Bernard Benoît, numéro 5, Olivier Danjou, numéro 6, Xavier Malot, numéro 7, Jérémy Rodrigue, numéro 8, Zacharia Barou, numéro 9, Arnaud Toupin, numéro 10, Benoît Napaco, numéro 11, Jerry Vajeda, numéro 12, Nicolas Jeté, numéro 14, Jérémy Tremblay, numéro 15, Alex-Pierre Torchon, numéro 16, Davide Pecoraro, numéro 17, Sam McTuff, numéro 20, Julien Paquet, numéro 21, Hugo Dufresne, numéro 22, Junior Kamara, numéro 23, Maxime Anabi, numéro 26, Christophe Pombrion, numéro 27, Mathieu Lacharté. Head coach, Moro DeChocio. Assistant coaches, Dean Howie, Taufik Lamoudi. Team therapist, Gabrielle Caron. And athletic director, Vince Amato. The silver medal winners, les gagnants de la médaille d'argent. Vancouver Island Mariners. Number one, Kevin Picard. Number two, Cole Senchar. Number three, Bradley Sager. Number four, Fraser Rideout. Number five, Grant Cooper. Number six, Diego Cornazzoli. Number seven, Michael Rappel. Number eight, Thompson Nelson. Number nine, Taylor Arbor. Number 10, Shun Takano. Number 11, Hector Valdez. Number 12, Travis Brown. Number 13, Reed Davidson. Number 14, Griffin Douglas. Number 15, Matthew McCoburn. Number 16, Malcolm Bagiopoulos. Number 17, Billy Bagiopoulos. Number 18, Josh Howes. Number 20, Grayson Chalifu. Number 21, Wesley Bischoff. Number 22, Nathan McGugan. Number 23, Kevin Mosmer. And number 24, Carson Croats. Head coach, Larry Stefanik. Assistant coach, Gary Smith. Assistant coach, Joel Harry. Athletic director, Stephanie White. And now, the gold medalist for the 2019 CCAA Men's Soccer Championship. Enfin, les médailles d'or du CCAA, Durham Lords. Number one, Kavon Grant. Number two, Ryan Cullen. Number three, Tyreek Bryan. Number four, Nicholas Payne. Number five, Kevin Smith. Number seven, Joshua Lee. Number eight, Aiden Donaldson. Number nine, Lerone Young. Number 10, Nicholas Spittle. Number 11, Marcellus Paul. Number 12, Jeremy Gondola. Number 13, Dylan Cohen. Number 14, Jose Flores. Number 16, Colin Ryan. Number 17, Marco Brusco. Number 18, Khalil Ledward John. Number 19, Nathaniel Payne. Number 20, Ryan Airy. Number 21, Isaiah Pastor. Number 24, Eric Savez. Number 22, Matthew Berry. And number 26, Ifo Idiona. Head coach, Dave Ashfield. Assistant coach, Ben Kramer. Associate coach, Bruce Cullen. Goalkeeper coach, John Milton. And trainers, Jordan Torres and Brennan McConaughey. Will now present the CCAA National Championship trophy and banner to the CCAA National Champion, your Durham Lords. We invite the team captain forward to receive a trophy and banner. Nous invitons les capitaines d'équipe à recevoir le trophée et la bannière.
Thank you.
Thank you.